My name is Pavel Křopala from BlenderFreak.com and welcome to the part number 30 of the Node Editor tutorial series. And in this part we are going to have a look on how to create windows here in our MDI area. So let's start coding. To create our new window, we are going to into calculator window. Let's go ahead and look for the actions. I will just delete these empty lines here. Okay, and here as you can see we got action new, which is calling on file new. This is this method here, and we are going to override that in the calculator window itself. Let's go here, and what we are going to say is we wanna create a new sub window, so sub VND is gonna equal to self.createMDIChild. And we can say sub vnd.show. So this function is gonna be pretty easy and simple. I'm going to close everything and put it just at the end. So define create MDI child, and that one is going to create the node editor widget. So node editor. And we are going to extend it, so let's call that calculator sub window. So let's create the instance of this class, and then we can just say self.mdi area.add sub window. And as you can see, the first attribute is qWidget, that's gonna be our node editor. So node editor, and this function creates from the widget qmdi sub window object. So sub vnd equals to this one, and we can just return sub vnd. So to define or create our calculator sub window, we are going to create a new class that's gonna be named calc underscore sub window like this, and we are going to extend our node editor widget, so from node editor dot node editor widget import node editor widget, and a class, I can paste the name here, extends node editor widget, and let's define the new constructor. So define underscore underscore init. And if I remember correctly, in the MDI example, which is here in the MDI child, we are in the constructor setting the attribute qt.wa delete on close. So I do wanna keep that. So self, we don't know qt. So from pyqt5.qt. Core import everything. Basically, for now, this is gonna be enough, I guess. Let's go to the calculate window. We need to import this one. So from examples.examplecalculator.calculatorSubwindow import calculatorSubwindow. Here it is. On file new should call this function and then show. So let's test it out. File new, and we got crash. So to find out what actually happened, we can use our try except exception as e and dump exception E. So let's try it again. Self.setAttribute qt blah blah blah, and exception superclass init of type calculator subwindow was never called. So to fix that, go ahead to the calculator subwindow. We do need to call super dot underscore init, like this, and this should fix our bug. So Control N, and as you can see, we got window, there is a node editor, which is awesome, and we can create more of them. We can go Control Tab between them, and we can have multiple instances of the node editor itself. But all of them are untitled, and window is not showing up our tabs or currently opened files. So for that, we can go ahead in the calculator subwindow and we can call something like self.setTitle, which will basically take care of our widget title, and we can ask for the file name which is being opened right here. And probably we are going to move that information or the logic or the functions to the node editor widget itself, because from the previous time, if I remember correctly, in the node editor window we are handling the file name in the node editor window. So let's go ahead and move this one. So cut and move that into the node editor widget itself. Over here, bunch of QSS styles, this is need to be refactored also. So move that here into the node editor widget. We can easily create new functions, and let's define the first one. That's gonna be is file name set, and we are going to return if self dot file name is not none. So this is gonna be a boolean, and we can also create a new function called get user friendly file name, and for that we wanna set name to be self dot file name, but in this case we are going to return all of the path from the disk and slashes, like you can see here, with all of the directories, and we don't need that, we just need the last part of it. And for that there is an awesome function in the OS module, so import OS, and in this package we can use os.path, that's another package, and base name. The base name is basically returning just the last part of the path. So we are going to return os path base name if self dot is file name set, and if it's not, we are going to return new graph. So new graph and return name. Here we can make just a note, so to do at star has been modified logic here. Okay, so this function should be ready. We can copy that out and go to the calculator subwindow, and here we are setting the title. So let's define the function. So define set title. This function is going to self.set window title and ask for self.getUserFriendly file name. Now when I press play and I choose Control N, the tab is called new graph. So this one works, and let's fix up our window menu. So that one was, I believe, in the calculator window. Here is update window menu, and there is bunch of code we commented out previously, and basically we are asking for the child user friendly current file name. We call that function differently, so let's copy the name here, go back to the calculator window and replace the name here. And here is the action we are adding each for each window which is opened in the MDI area, we are adding a new action, and we are asking is if the child is self.activeMDIChild. So for that function, we don't have that either. So let's go ahead to the MDI, and I believe it was in the main window, the end. Here is activeMDIChild. So let's copy this, go back to the calculator window, and we are going to create function. So paste it here. What we are doing here is basically we are asking MDI area for the active sub window, and if we got one, then we are returning the widget. So we can write a note here. We are returning node editor widget here. So basically, in our case, we call that calculator subwindow. Probably we should rename that, but for now it's gonna work. So let's try if we will crash or if we are going to work. So file new window. We got four graphs open. The third one, this is the second one. First one, we can switch between them. So that works like a charm. So in our case, we moved the file name from the node editor window up to the node editor widget. So definitely we broke up our node editor, our original example. As you can see, it doesn't even run. So let's go ahead and have a look here. We are trying to change title in the node editor window, and we are asking for the self file name. But I believe we got self.nodeEditor, which is the instance of the node editor widget. So here we should say something like node editor dot file name, and we can ask if the file name is none, or we can just directly use this function here. So if the file name is set, it's gonna be new, and self.centralWidget, the scene has been modified. I don't like this either, so let's go up here in the node editor widget, and we can ask directly the widget if it was modified. So define is modified, and I will keep the naming like this, because most of the, or I believe all of the Qt 5 elements are using some kind of this function as is modified. And we can just return here if self.scene. Has been modified like this. So let's go to the node editor window back, and instead of this, we can ask is modified. And here is a bunch of places we are asking for the self.centralWidget. And if you have a look at the calculator, the open will crash exactly because we are not overriding the file open method right now. But if you have a look in the node editor window or the actions, here is action open on the file open. We are always asking for the self.centralWidget. But in our calculator example, our central widget is going to be MDI area, and MDI area is going to contain subwindows and never going to have the scene directly. So maybe we can reuse a bunch of the code here, but we need to fix this one. So instead of set central widget, we can go ahead and create a new function and ask for the node editor itself, for the current instance which we want to change. And maybe we can put it I believe here, after the is modified, so define get current node editor widget, and for now in the example here we can just return self.central widget like this, and this is going to work for now, especially in our case of the node editor. And we can later rename or override this function with some different logic, and hopefully all of our functions like is modified are going to work also, because we are going to change the code here. So let's try that. Node editor window doesn't have file name. Here the title is new, so we can change that. We can basically strip all of the logic here and say title plus equals self dot get current node editor widget dot get user friendly file name. And if it was modified, we are adding a star to the title, but we are going to call get current node editor widget instead of the what have been the central widget which we were using to before. So let's try to find all of that and let's try to replace that with get current node editor widget. So basically here get current node editor widget, we wanna skip that one, but here on file new, replace, file open, replace, save, edit undo, redo, delete, edit cut, definitely edit copy, this one is paste, so replace, and nothing else was found. So let's try to run the node editor. We got a new graph. Once I start moving around, here we got no change. And to investigate why our node editor example, the first one, is not even showing the star there, let's go ahead into the node editor widget is modified and ask for the has been modified. And as you can see, we made a quick change. So we basically are returning always false in the has been modified, which messes up with everything we have been writing. So let's try to delete this line. When I press play, you can see we got the star back again, which is awesome. Once I close it, I get about to lose work, and I do want to keep that. So go back to the calculator window, let's create a new one, move that around, and here's no star. So let's fix it in our calculator sub window, that's here, and here we can basically go ahead and return name plus, and we are going to decide if we are going to add or append the star asterisk char or not. We are going to append it if self.isModified, otherwise we are not going to append it at all. So let's try it out. When I move it, it didn't change. And it didn't change because no actually set title was called. And to fix that, I'm going to calculator sub window, because we wanna make the same thing we are doing in the node editor window itself. And we need to add has been modified listener even to our sub window. So self dot note editor widget, but in our case we are already note editor widget, so self dot scene, it has been modified listener, and in our case it's gonna be called set title. So let's try to run that. File new, and you can see the star appeared. So if I do file new, we got new graph, and the old one is with star because we made changes, and in window first one is with star and the second one is not, which is awesome. So we managed to fix our logic and behavior, and we can think about if when we are calling the note editor widget here or the window here, and we are having a function which is called change title, if we actually do wanna do it the same way we are doing it in the calculator window or the sub window, I mean here with the set window title. But for now I believe the calculator sub window is something a little bit different than a window, so we can basically keep it the same as it is. Just for consistency, I'm going to the note editor window and I'm going to change or rename this function to set title. And I'm going to do refactoring. This function is being called from the file new, init UI, and the file open. So let's go ahead. All of it was changed, which is awesome. So let's test out our note editor example. Here we go. Here we got double star. So the note editor window, we are adding a star to this one. We don't need to do that anymore because we are having this logic in the widget. Let's try it again. And we got one single star here, which is awesome. So just quickly test if the open is working. And it's not. We got a crash. So we will probably fix that in some later part. So thank you for watching and see you at the next part.